Hello everyone. Welcome to the third session of Network Layer under VTU eShikshana program. In the last session, we discussed router architecture. In this session, we will understand internet protocol and addressing. Coming to the internet protocols and addressing, it is the third layer of communication protocol hierarchy, which specifies the networking aspects of communication transaction. And this internet protocol layer handles networking aspects and establishes routes for packet network. This IP is very much important. Without IP address, we cannot identify any system in the network. Using the IP address, you can send a message from one network to the another network. And the third layer of communication protocol hierarchy is the network layer. In OSI reference model, there are seven layers. Those are physical layer, data link layer, network layer. The third layer, network layer, is responsible for IP address. Here, the routing takes place. Next is transport layer, session layer, presentation layer, and application layer. Right. The network layer, in fact, handles the method of addressing address to packet and determine how they should be forwarded from one point to the another point. So the network layer, in fact, handles the method of assigning address to packets and determines how they should be forwarded from one point to another, that is from source to destination. The network layer is responsible for assigning the address to packets. And IP address plays very important role in identifying the network and host. Next, internet protocol produces a header for packets. An IP header contains the IP address of a source node and a destination node respectively. An IP packet can be encapsulated in the layer 2 frames when the packet enters a LAN. We all know data link layer deals with frame, whereas the physical layer deals with bits and the network layer deals with packets. So the IP layer normally offers no quality of service guarantees and provides best effort services. It just sends the packet from one network to the another network. It offers no quality of service guarantee, that is throughput, delay, efficiency, performance, those things. And IP is inherently unreliable, that is relying completely on higher layer such as transport protocol to handle issues relating to system reliability. It completely depends on higher layer, and IP is inherently unreliable. It is not reliable. So, coming to internet protocol services, IP provides smooth, that is seamless internet connectivity and scalability. This layer is based on connectionless or so-called datagram switching approach. So, it is connectionless, it is not connection oriented, and the advantage of this kind of service are flexibility to allow interconnection between diverse network topologies, and second one is robustness to node failure. So because of this connectionless feature, it is very flexible to connect with other networks. No need to establish connection. Next, apart from the ability to connect a diverse network, the IP layer also fragments packets to the maximum transmission unit and performs a reassembly of packet fragments at destination. See, you all know the network has some capacity based on that the sender has to send the packets. The size of the packet should be within maximum transmission unit. Otherwise, the packet has to be fragmented. That is, the physical capacity of networks enforces an upper bound on the size of packets. The maximum transmission unit represents this restriction, right? To be successfully reassembled at the destination, the fragment packets is reassembled to get the original message. All fragments making up a packet must arrive at the destination. So in case of missing fragments, the rest of the fragments have to be discarded. So the reassembly of packet fragments at destination is very much important to get the original message. The reassembly takes place at the destination. To be successfully reassembled, for this, all fragments making up a packet must arrive at the destination. In case of a missing fragment, if any fragment is missing, then rest of the fragments will be discarded and the packet needs to be retransmitted. So in such cases, retransmission of packet results in an inefficient use of the network bandwidth. For this purpose, it is unreliable. Coming to the packet format of IP version 4, see, in the figure you can see the IPv4 packet format. It consists of version, header length, type of service, datagram length, etc. And it is a 32-bit. It is a 32-bit address. And the version is 4-bit, and header length is 4-bit, and type of service is 8-bit. It is a 8-bit type of service is 8-bit. It specifies the type of service. And flag is 3-bit, and 13-bit fragmentation offset, time to live, upper layer protocol, header checksum, and this is the IP address of source, IP address of destination, and it is 32-bit long, options if any, and this is the data. IPv4 is 32-bit long, and version represents the IP protocol version, that is IPv4 or IPv6. In this case, it is IPv4. And header length is of 4 bits. It specifies the length of the IPv4 header. It specifies the length of the IPv4 header. So in this way, for each field, a separate description is there, and we will see in the next slide. That is, each packet comprises the header and data. The size of the header is variable, with 20 bytes of fixed length header and an optional field whose size is variable up to 40 bytes. So here a brief description of the field is given. The first field, that is version, specifies the IP version. That is, it is of 4 bits. It specifies whether it is IPv4 or IPv6. And the next is header length. This specifies the length of the header. So it is also again 4 bits. And coming to the type of services, that is the quality of service requirements of the packet, such as the priority level, delay, reliability, throughput, and cost. So it is 8 bits. That is, the type of service is the 8 bits, and specifies the type of service. The field takes effect only in the differentiated service model. So it is affected when comes to the differentiated service model, such as a priority level, delay, reliability, throughput, and cost are some of the metrics of quality of service. Next, coming to the total length, it specifies the total length of the packet in bytes, including the header and data. A total of 16 bits are assigned to this field. It is of 16 bits. That is, this is datagram length. Right, it is 16 bits. 16 datagram length, 16 bit identifier. Identifier is 16 bit. Total length is also 16 bits. Total length is 16 bits. Identifier identification is 16 bit again. Identification flag and fragment offset are used for packet fragmentation and reassembly. It is again 16 bit. IPv4 software maintains a counter in the storage device to record the number of IP datagrams. The counter value increases by one every time a datagram is sent and is filled in the identification field. So a packet has identifier, sequence number to recover from the error and for retransmission. And coming to the flag uses 3 bits, and fragmentation offset is 13 bit. Fragmentation offset is 13 bit, and time to live is again 8 bits. That specifies the lifespan of a datagram on the network. See, time to live specifies the maximum number of hops after which a packet must be discarded. So time to live specifies the lifetime or lifespan of a datagram on a network. After that, it is discarded. And protocol specifies the type of protocol carried in the datagram. Protocol specifies the protocol used at the destination. And header checksum is a method of error detection. So a device calculates the header checksum for each datagram received. If the checksum is zero, the device knows that the header remains unchanged and retains the datagram. This field checks only the header but not the data. So header checksum is a method of error detection. Right. And if the checksum is zero, the header remains unchanged and retains the datagram. If the checksum is one, it is discarded. Next, the source address and the destination address are 32-bit fields specifying the source address and the destination address respectively. It maintains the address of source and destination, and it is of 32-bit long. And the option is a rarely used variable length field to specify security level, timestamp, and type of route. And the source address is 32-bit long, specifies the IPv4 address of a sender, and destination IP is also 32-bit long and specifies the IPv4 address of a receiver. And option is rarely used, that is 0 to 40 bytes, it is a variable length, and data is also a variable length, that is a padding is used to ensure that the header is a multiple of 32 bits. See, data is again variable in length, and padding takes place, pads and IP datagram. The padding takes place at the data is used to, padding is used to ensure that the header is a multiple of 32 bits. And the option allows IPv4 to support various options such as fault handling and security, etc. Coming to the IP addressing scheme, the IP header as 32 bit assigned for addressing a desired device in the network. IPv4 is a 32 bit long, and an IP address is a unique address, and it is a unique identifier used to locate a device on the IP network. Every device in the network is identified by the IP address, right? Without IP address, you cannot recognize the system. And to make the system scalable, the address structure is subdivided into the network ID and the host ID. So if you know the IP address, easily you can identify the network ID and the host ID, right? IP address is a unique identifier which is used to identify the device in the network. Every device has an IP address and it is unique. And the IP address has two parts. One is network ID, another is the host ID. So IP is a 32 bit long, and it is subdivided into network ID and the host ID. The network ID identifies the network the device belongs to, and the host ID identifies the device. This implies that all devices belong to the same network have single network ID. So here you have to understand, IP address has two part. One is network ID and the host ID. Every device has IP address, and using IP address you can identify the host belongs to which network and what is the host address. So based on the bit positioning assigned to the network ID and the host ID, the IP address is further subdivided into class A, B, C, D and E. That is, bit positioning represents the address belongs to which class. For example, if the bit starts from 0, then it is a class A. If bit starts from 10, then it is class B. If bits starts from 110, then it is a class C. Like this, it continues. In the coming slide, we will see more about classful address. So IP addressing scheme. In IP address, 32 bits are there, and it is subdivided into network ID and the host ID, and every device is identified by the IP address in the network, and IP address is unique address, right? And network ID identifies the network, and host ID identifies the device. Coming to the classful addressing, there are different classes like A, B, C, D, and E. 5 classes are there, and the 32-bit IP address is subdivided, divided into 5 subclasses. IPv4 is divided into 2 parts. One is network ID and another is host ID. So there are 5 subclasses. 32-bit IP address is divided into 5 subclasses: A, B, C, D, and E. How it is identified as A, B, C, D, and E, we will see. See, classes of IP address: class A, class B, class C, D and E. IP addresses are globally managed by Internet Assigned Number Authority and regional internet registries. So IP address is managed by IANA, Internet Assigned Number Authority. This agency gives the IP address, right? Consider class A. In class A, network ID is 8 bit and host ID is 24 bit. So you all know IP address is 32 bit long, and 4 octets are there, 1, 2, 3, 4, in first byte. That is a net ID, network ID is identified by 8 bits. In 32 bit, 8 bit identifies the network ID and remaining 24 bits. are used for host ID. In coming to the class B, 16 bits, that is byte 1, byte 2, 2 bytes, that is 1 byte is equal to 8 bits. So 16 bits are used for the network ID and remaining 16 bits are used for host ID. You all know IP address is 32 bit long. In IP address, there are two parts. One is network ID, another one is the host ID. In class A, 8 bits represent network ID and the remaining 12 bits, that is 24 bits, right? 8, 16, 24 bits represent host ID. Next, in class B, 16 bits represents network ID and the 16 bit represents host ID. In class C, 24 bits represent network ID and 8 bits represent host ID. Next, coming to the class D, class D is used for multicast address and class E is reserved for experiment purpose. See, IP address classification. How the IP address is classified as A, B, C, D, and E. This is what the bit position. See, in 8 bit, the first bit is reserved, that is 0. And the remaining is net ID, that is network ID. And here, host ID is 24 bits. See, this is how the class A, B, C, D, and E are classified. So, if the starting bit is 0, then it is class A. In 8 bits, the first bit is reserved. And there are 2 to the power of 7 networks. And in each network, there are 2 to the power of 24 hosts. Okay. Next, coming to the class B. In class B, 16 bits are used for network ID and 16 bits are used for host ID. In that 16 bits, the 2 bits are reserved, that is 1 and 0. So 2 to the power of 14 networks are there and 2 to the power of 16 hosts in each network. I repeat, see, in class B, 16 bits are used for network ID and 16 bits are used for host ID. So in 16 bit, 2 bits are reserved, that is 1 and 0. So 14 bits constitute network ID. In class B, there are 2 to the power of 14 networks and in each network, 2 to the power of 16 hosts will be there. Whereas in class A, in each network, 2 to the power of 24 hosts will be there. So the network is too big to handle. And there are 2 to the power of 7 networks. Coming to the class C, in class C, there are 24 bits for network ID and 8 bits for host ID. So in that 24 bits, 3 bits are reserved, that is 110. If the IP address starts with 110, then it is clear it belongs to class C. So the network ID is 21 bits. Therefore, 2 to the power of 21 networks will be there. And in each network, 2 to the power of 8 hosts will be there. And the class D is multicast. It starts with 1110 and the class E is reserved for experiment. It starts with 1111. So, in detail, if we see, then you will come to know what is class A, B, C, D, and E. That is, class A starts with 0 and supports 126 networks and 16 million hosts per network. So, it starts with 0. In 8 bits, 1 bit is reserved, so 7 bits are there. Therefore, 2 to the power of 7 networks. And in each network, 2 to the power of 24 hosts will be there. So, 16 million hosts per network. In each network, there are so 16 million nodes you can have. So, it is very huge network. And class B addressing always starts with 10. The class B address always starts with 10 and supports 16,382 networks, and in each network 65,534 hosts per network. And in each network 65,534 hosts will be there. So class B, you are having more networks compared to class A. In class A, only 126 network, but the size of the network is too big. That is 16 million nodes, or 16 million system, or 16 million hosts will be having in every network. And coming to the class B, there are 16,382 network, and in each network 65,534 hosts will be there, because 2 to the power of 16 is this much. That is 65,534 hosts per network. Coming to the class C, starting with 110 and supports 2 million networks, and in each network 254 hosts will be there. That is 254 hosts per network. 254 hosts. So here you are going to get huge networks, and in each network few hosts will be there. That is 254 hosts per network, because 21 bits are used to identify network ID. That is, class C is identified with 110, because of that there are 21 bits. Therefore, 2 to the power of 21 networks. In each network, 2 to the power of 8 hosts will be there. 110 is reserved here. Among 84 bits, 110 is reserved. So, 3 bits reserved. Net ID is 21. Next, class D address starts with 1110 and is specifically designed for multicasting and broadcasting. Class E always starts with 1111, reserved for network experiments. Right. See, the class C in 32 bits, 24 bits are used for net ID, and 8 bits are used for host ID. In 24 bits, 3 bits are reserved. So remaining 21 bits represents net ID. Therefore, 2 to the power of 21 network will be there in class C, and in each class 2 to the power of 8 hosts will be there. Right. For ease of use, the IP address is represented in dotted decimal notation. The address is grouped into 4 dot separated bytes. 4 dot, that is, in example, you can see here a host with an IP address. See, this is first octet, second octet, third octet, and fourth octet in binary form. It belongs to class B because it starts with 10. And its decimal equivalent is 136, 229, 201, and 16. If you convert this to digital, if you convert this to decimal, you will get this. That is 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128. So this is how you have to convert. So 16, this binary represent decimal number 16. And it belongs to class B because it starts with 10. Right. See, class A, in detail if you go, then you will come to know what is class A, what is class B. In class A, IP address belongs to class A are assigned to the network, then it contains large number of hosts, so it is difficult for the network administrator to manage. And what is the range of class A address? See, IP address belongs to class A are assigned to the network that contain large number of hosts. The network ID is 8 bit long and the host ID is 24 bit long. And the higher order bit of the first octet in class A is always set to 0. So the remaining 7 bits in the first octet are used to determine the network ID. Therefore, the 24 bits of the host ID are used to determine the host in any network. The default subnet mask is 255.0.0.0. Therefore, class A has a total number of 126 network ID. Here minus 2. Why minus 2? Means the first address is 00 and the second is 127.0.0.1. It is considered as the loopback address. It's considered as the loopback address, and this is the default address. 000 is the default address. So minus 2. And here also 2 to the power of 24 minus 2. We always subtract minus 2 because the first and last address is not used. The first address is used for network ID and the last address is used for a default broadcast address. It is a default broadcast address. Excluding 2, the remaining numbers are used in network ID also and also in the host ID. So IP address belonging to class A ranges from 1 to 0 to 127. In that, 0 and 127 is not used. 0 is the default address and 127.0.0.1 is the loopback address. So here that is the class A. Class A is starts with 0 and 7 bits for network ID, 24 bits for host ID. And coming to class B, IP address belongs to class B are assigned to the network that ranges from medium sized to large sized network. See, class A is used for huge organization. If the organization is too big, if the institution is too big, then class A is used. Class A is used in Pentagon, NASA, such type of organization use class A address, because here the network is too big. It is difficult for the administrator to manage, because in each network there are 2 to the power of 24 hosts will be there. That is 2 to the power of 24 minus 2 hosts will be there in each network. The network is only 126 and the size of the each network is too big. That is this many hosts will be there. 16 million hosts will be there in each network. So coming to the IP address class B, that is class B. IP address belongs to class B are assigned to the network that ranges from mid-sized to large-sized network. Here the network ID is 16 bit long and the host ID is 16 bit long. The higher order bit of the first octet of IP address of class B are always set to 10. So the remaining 14 bits are used to determine the network ID. That's why 2 to the power of 14 what 2 to the power of 14 networks and in each network 2 to the power of 16 minus 2, that is 65,534. Why 2? Because the first address is used for network address and the second and the last address. First and the last address is not used in every network. That is, the last address is a direct broadcast address. The default subnet mask of the class B is 255.255.0.0, that is .x.x. So the IP address belong to class B ranges from 128.0.0.0 to 191.0.0.0. So 0 to 127 is class A. In that class, 0 and 127 is not used. 0 is default address, 127 is the loopback address. And 128 to 191 is class B. 0 to 127 is class A. From 128 to 191 is class B. So in that higher order bit 1 and 0 are fixed. So 14 bits are used for network ID and 16 bits are used for host ID. in each network 2 to the power of 16 minus 2 hosts will be there, and the number of network here is 2 to the power of 14, right? That is 2 to the power of 14, 16,384 network address you are going to have. Network for every network address will be there, for every host address will be there. So IP address is divided into network ID and the host ID. If you know the IP address, easily you can identify the network. In network, host will be there, and you can recognize host also, and you can easily say this host belongs to this particular network. Next is IP address belong to class C are assigned to small sized networks. The network ID is 24 bit long and the host ID is 8 bit long. The higher order bit of the first octet of IP address of class C are always set to 110. So in 24 bit, 3 bits are reserved. The remaining 21 bits are used to determine the network ID. Therefore, there are 2 to the power of 21 networks, and in each network, 2 to the power of 8 minus 2 host will be there. So the 8 bits of the host ID is used to determine the host in any network. The default subnet of the class C is 255.255.255. See, here 3 bits are reserved, that's why 255.255.255.0. And there 2 bits are reserved, that's why 255.255. Here 1 bit is reserved, that's why 255.0.0. This is how you can easily remember. And the IP address belong to class B ranges from 128 to 191, and the IP address of class C ranges from 192 to 223. See here 0 to 127 class A, 128 to 191 class B, 192 to 223 class C, right? IP address ranges to belonging to class C ranges from 192 to 223. 21 bit is used for network, 8 bit is used for host. So 2 to the power of 21 network will be there. In each network, 2 to the power of 8 minus 2 host will be there. Minus 2, why? First and last address is not used. First address is used for network ID, and the last address is used for direct broadcast address. Coming to the class D, IP address belonging to class D are reserved for multicasting. And the higher order bits of the first octet of IP addresses belonging to class D are always set to 1110. So the remaining bits are for the addresses that interested host recognize. And here the range is, class D does not possess any subnet mask. The subnet mask is applicable only for class A, B and C, and IP addresses belonging to class D ranges from 224 to 239, that is here 192 to 223, 224 to 239 is class D. Next, coming to class E, IP addresses belonging to class E are reserved for experimental and research purpose. So IP addresses of class E ranges from 240 to 255. This class doesn't have any subnet mask. So the higher order bit of first octet of class E are always set to 1111. So this is about classful addresses. In next class, we will understand CIDR notation, classless inter-domain routing. Thank you.